Hey there. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Yep, thank you, thank you. I'm back from my sickness. I was sick yesterday. You know what I did? Not a fucking thing. Just lay on the couch and laid in my bed. Then went and laid on the couch and laid in my bed and ate oatmeal. But I have a feeling my sick voice is gonna make me sound extra sexy, ladies. I feel like maybe I should put on something sexier for y'all, ladies. What's up, girl? I got a head cold. That's why I sound this good. Alright, so what do we have today? Justin Hunt's gonna come in and talk about Nipsey Hussle. He was murdered this weekend. And there's been more news today, actually. So we'll share that with you. Hater to love it. Hey John, some dude, did you see someone send some shit saying it was, I said to send it?
Yeah.
Can you hit him back?
Yes, I will.
Cause guess who gets bothered? Take a wild guess who gets bothered by them.
That would be you.
Yeah, I get bothered by them.
So I'm gonna hook this guy up though?
Yeah, or at least double check with me. If someone says Jude told me to hook you up, just fucking, hey, is this a dude? Yeah, and I'll say yeah, and then you can go ahead with that. You just like me getting fucking phone calls when I'm sick.
Phone calls? This guy's calling you?
Yeah, he called me. I've known him since forever, dude. That's why I was like, yeah, sure, fucking do it.
Oh, okay.
Should they put that in the fucking, in the subject line, how long they've known me, too?
Wouldn't hurt.
You fucking asshole. None of my friends ever, nobody I know from back in the day ever calls me up bugging me about getting some money. It's always like, hey, can you do me a favor? I hate to bother you, but I still need that favor. One more last time about the fucking favor. Let's talk to Josh in Tampa. Josh.
Jude. Big fan, buddy.
Awesome. Appreciate you. How you doing?
Yeah, I was calling. I was thinking about you yesterday. I learned a hard lesson. You never pay a hooker up front, my man.
You got got too?
Oh, I got. Bitch had a head cold so bad, I give her $40 up front. She starts sucking my dick while I'm driving around, right?
Yeah.
And maybe not even a minute, pulls out, hawks out this big-ass loogie out my window.
Oh.
Just coughing and coughing. Oh. Bitch takes my fucking cup, my soda from the gas station, opens up the lid and goes, you ain't gonna drink this, right? Fucking just starts hacking up green shit. So I'm getting gross, like gagging to myself. And this bitch just staring, keeps going. Tries to go down on me, turns around, fucking hocks another one in my cup. Sucks, man.
You might, this is not jokes.
Get tested?
You might have strep dick. Hey, bro, you laughing? That shit happened to me, man.
No.
Yeah.
All I could think about was the massage parlor chick with the fucking head pulled, man. I'm just waiting on it. Something's going to creep up, I'm telling you.
Yeah, I'm dead ass, bro. You can get strep dick. You can get, like, whatever the fuck that, whatever.
You mean it gets all, like, red and itchy or what?
Nah, it's like, It burns when you pee in the whole nine. It feels like you got a venereal disease.
Those ain't no fun. All right, brother.
Yeah, man.
Wow. Learned the hard way, I guess.
You did. I waited for this. This was way back in the day. A woman that worked for Sirius. And once she stopped working for Sirius, a few months afterwards, she like came by and like gave me head while she had strep throat and gave me strep dick. That's why if someone's like, I got a cold, I'm like, hey, it's cool, man. Feel better.
Have you ever heard of a $40 hooker though? $40?
Maybe you picked her up at the motherfucking, at the goddamn, where the truck drivers go. Maybe she was a lot lizard. Shit's higher down there in Florida.
It's a good deal.
Hey, truckers, call up. What are whores going for nowadays? The lot lizard ones. I think they're all on fucking on. They used to be on fucking Backpage and. Was it Andy's List or what is it?
Craigslist. $40 though. That's a screaming deal.
Yep, it is a good deal. At least she sucked our, like, at least she, I gave my hooker money and she just robbed me. At least she was trying. John in Cincinnati.
What's going on, man? Big fan, brother.
Thanks, bro. What's your question?
I'm curious. The previous guy is talking about massage parlors, right?
No, he's talking about a hooker that he picked
right,
up.
A hooker, whatever. Massage parlor, same thing in my book, but
no, not really. But okay.
Okay, there's hookers at massage parlors, right?
Some.
Okay, well, around here in Cincinnati, there's all these massage parlors getting busted left and right. And my question is, how do you know which massage parlors you can go to for the happy endings, and how do you know which ones you can't? I mean, it ain't like there's a motherfucking menu board up when you walk in there talking about blowjobs and hand jobs and some pussy. So what do you say to these motherfuckers when you walk in there? Like, y'all suck dick?
That's exactly what you say. Yeah, that's exactly what you say.
That's what you say. You just walk in there and y'all suck dick in here.
Yep. You go in there, you say, who do I got to blow to get my dick sucked in here?
Right.
Yo, if they tell you to keep your underwear on, that's a good sign that they're not doing anything extracurricular. Your best.
Or you just get on the table, you just pull that motherfucker out for him, huh?
Man, you're annoying to talk to. Is it because I got a head cold, or is he just like kind of like fucking? It's me. Okay, I don't just pull it out. I fucking if they say get all the way naked, then that means they might be into it. If they're telling you to keep your clothing on, that means that they're not into it. And sometimes they'll even have like these weird hammer pants they make you wear to let you know that they're extra not doing it. But this one, John, I'm gonna put you up on game. They got this shit called Rub Maps, and you can look up shit on Rub Maps. And I think you can pay. I think it's you can pay for it, and it's worth it. It's worth dropping $20 to find out where the spots are. You know, who does what when.
All right.
You see what I'm saying?
Well, I appreciate the heads up, man.
Yeah. That's a real shit. Cause look, man, I think one of the last times I did a bunch of acid, and I was like, oh, I was walking around, I was like, oh, this is awesome. I want to get a fucking hand job. And I walked in on the place.
Right.
And it was in the hood. So like, I thought, all right, I'm good. So I walk in and I pay. And then she's like, go in this room and get undressed, but leave on your underwear. And I was like, nope, this ain't it. So I put my, I was like, I turned around. I was like, hey, I need my money back. She was like, well, I said, I'm looking for a different kind of massage. And they're like, what? And
right.
I showed them like the jerk off hand motion. I was like, I'm looking for the jerk off massage. And they started talking to each other in Thai. And I'm sitting there waiting for them to like, maybe they'll change their mind. But they didn't. So I just fucking got my money and left. So there you go.
That's what's up. At least you ain't lose out on no ends, right?
Yeah. I mean, I really bummed out those old ladies, but whatever, man. Don't get mad at me. That's the thing. It's like, hey, look, man. Don't get mad at this guy for going into your place thinking I'm going to get a fucking rub and tug. Because half the time I'll be right. Get mad at them rub and tug ladies that look just like your spot that gives out the rub and tugs. Unika was a hooker. She knows all the price. Ex-hooker. Unika.
Hi, how you doing, Jude? I want to shout out Shay 45. I thought you was a nigga for a long time. Ain't nothing wrong with you being white, though. But I thought you was a nigga. I still like you.
All right, I appreciate that. Now, what type of...
Yeah, I put that on your Instagram, too.
No shit. Well, thank you. What type of prostitute were you? Were you a call girl?
I stood on the corners of Figueroa.
Okay.
Engaged in Los Angeles. Like, you know, I know y'all know where a famous Figueroa is.
Yes, I do know where Figueroa is.
I sit on a couple corners over there, Long Beach Boulevard. I'm not saying, like, I'm a proud hoe, but, like, sex work is a job, you know. I still have to do what I do to get my ends together. But $40 is, like, for smoker hoes. Like, y'all know what a strawberry is, right? John, you probably don't know. But a strawberry is, like, a hoe that is on drugs now, and all she do is hoe for drugs. So, like, I don't know no real hoes that take it $40 for, like, a blowjob and sex. Like, I want at least $100 and using a condom.
Yeah.
And that's, like, 10 minutes.
Yeah.
So, I don't know what type of... And then, like, talk about lot lizards. Like, that's, like, you know, like, truck stops and all that. I've been there, too, like, in Pomona and Arizona. And, like, you know, like, when I'm crossing states, I stop at truck stops. But, like, still, like, you got to know your worth. You just can't take anything because you a prostitute.
Yeah, and they're fucking up the pricing for everybody else, too.
Yeah, like, if you start taking anything, you gonna lower the value for everybody else, and they're going to think, like, everybody going to take that, especially with you that start doing bareback. That's no condom. You're not a real prostitute if you're not using a condom. I don't care what she says, how she says it. That bitch is dirty. Don't do it.
Thank you very much. I appreciate the insider look on this. I'm going to put you on hold so we can give you something for free. Some lube or some shit. Give her some promescent lube. Shauna. Damn, they really spelled your name different. Go ahead, Shauna.
Okay, so I'm calling from Corpus Christi, Texas, and you can still get a blowjob for $20 here. There's a, you know, you just got to go to the right spot. In town, and I think everybody knows that spot because once sundown comes, you got people sneaking up and down the streets. And you know, I think it's just a mixed lot. Sometimes there are some busted hoes, and sometimes there's some decent ones. But I think at the end of the day, if you are going for a blowjob, $20 is not bad.
That's a fucking
then again,
steal.
Our minimum wage in Texas is $7.25 an hour, so they're still, you know,
yeah, rent's a little cheap. Ahead. How much is rent down there in Texas?
It's about $1,000 actually, upwards of like $1,000 a month for like a 3-bedroom, 2-bedroom house.
Oh, $1,000? Yeah, no, yeah, $20 blowjobs. That makes sense for $1,000 for a 3-bedroom.
Yeah, so it's a little more affordable. But again, I mean, you're not. I don't think you're getting like, you know, fucking Heidi Fleiss.
You're not getting Cindy Crawford.
Girls, but you know, it sounds to me like. If you're willing to let somebody suck your dick when you have, you know, when she has strep throat, your standards aren't that high anyway. So, fuck it. Oh, and I was referencing the guy that called with the green flames, but
you weren't talking about me. Yeah, well, sure, but I'll take that.
I wasn't talking about you, but it sounds like you learned your lesson as well. Because I mean, I think you can probably, you know, it's like what's the saying? One time, shame on
you.
Them. Now, right.
Two times.
I don't think you'll repeat that. It sounds like you're not. So that's good.
Yep. Thank you so much for your
my insight.
Yes. I really appreciate you. Yeah, you be well. Yeah. Oh, hold up. I got to highlight Marcus, and then we're going to have Justin come in. Marcus in Cleveland. What up, man?
What's going on, brother? Let me hit the horn for you two times.
Go ahead. Mm-hmm. My man. Go ahead.
Hey, when I was doing Uber down in Virginia, I picked this girl up a couple of times. She finally told me she was a call girl, and she broke down the prices for me. She was like, because I was like, how you charge? She was like, well, in Petersburg, small town, something like that. She's like, this is straight up $60 an hour. Mm. Now, she say when she go to Cali, she get $250 an hour.
It's about right.
Yeah. Yeah, but like the other lady was talking about with a condom. She's like, she don't even let dudes eat her out or nothing.
Yeah. In my book, when I was talking about eating out the hooker, I was like, that was pretty. I thought I got AIDS. I was really scared. I was like, oh no, I'm gonna die. I shouldn't have done that at all. I'm disgusting.
Girl, 24 years old, nice ass crib, Jag in the driveway, and that was all hers. I was like, you doing it like that? She's like, yeah. She hit up Cali, Florida, Virginia, where she live in Virginia, but New York. I was like, damn. Yeah, she getting that bread, though.
You got to put some away, though, ladies. Put some of that money away, because you can't. You don't want to be like the $50-year-old whore. St. Q.
Hey.
What up, though, St. Q? You pimping out in
Chicago.
Man,
how y'all doing out there?
Shit, we good, man. Why don't you break it down? Sprinkle us with a little touch of game.
Man, you know, just like this, man. I'm coming out of Miami right now, right?
All right.
And I'm on my way. I'm from Chicago, but on my way to Houston. So I've been all over the bubble with this, man, you know, all over the country. And it's pretty much, it's the same old game, you know, but it's priced a little differently everywhere. And just because, to be honest with you, you know, since Backpage got taken down, they done fucked up a lot of shit, you know what I'm saying? The internet really, really fucked up the game. This Instagram really fucked up the game. You know what I'm saying? These girls on Instagram, you know what I'm saying? I don't even know how the fuck these hoes getting paid, but they just on there popping pussy and some old shit. And they got the game to the point where, you know, these girls, they basically have to settle for what they can get nowadays, because you got so many girls out there giving it up for free. They make it hard for the hoes to eat. You understand what I'm saying?
They're flooding the market.
Yeah, you know, so it's hard. And he said, like, I heard the girl from Corpus Christi talking about $20. Man, I wish a bitch of mine would suck a dick for $20. The reason why they suck a dick for $20 in Corpus Christi is because it's a bunch of, with no disrespect, but there's a bunch of Hispanics down there, and that the living is hard. They'll pretty much do whatever. And then they don't have any lines. Now that, like I said, Backpage is fucked up, they don't really have anywhere to buy any pussy down there. So, you know, you got the Padre Island that's down there. They don't have a line where the girls can, you know what I'm saying, where they can make money, you know. So shit is just fucked up. Like, Houston is oversaturated with bitches. So you got even the baddest bitches on there, you know, settling for $80, you know what I'm saying, for a half hour and stuff like that. It's just, you know, it's just the game is watered down, you know, and shit, it's getting hard and hard out here to eat, man. No matter what you say, no matter what kind of bitch you got, or who the bitch is, she ain't always getting $1,000 every day. You know, like dude said that she had a Jag and all that. You know, that's cool, but he probably don't know how long it took her to get that shit. Or if the motherfucker, they could be looking for that shit. Motherfuckers not making $1,000 every day, every fucking day, for 7 days a week straight. That's bullshit.
Thank you.
That's not the reality.
You know? Yes. Appreciate you, thank you. That was thank you. Breaking down that pimp type shit. Alright, we're gonna play some music. Wait, hold up. Man, I feel like, hold on 1 sec. Here it is, little like a pimp.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
And now, here's the breakdown.
Breakdown
with Justin Hunt.
What's up, Just?
Jude, how you doing, sir?
Man, I'm all right. We had a tough weekend, huh?
It's a tragic situation. Not only for hip hop, not for music, not for LA, for the world. Sincerely.
Yeah. It was nuts. For those of you that don't know, Nipsey Hussle was murdered out front of his own store.
In front of the Marathon clothing. The Marathon is his brand. It's also, in my view, it's a testament to the community, you know. It's his legacy, and he was outside in front of his store. Reports say that he got into an argument with someone who was known in the community, known within the Crip set. Nipsey Hussle was a Crip, and there was a disagreement. The guy left, came back, shot Nipsey Hussle. Murdered him in front of his store. Three people were shot. Nipsey was pronounced dead on his way to the hospital. The footage, the camera footage was released. It looked like the guy shot him, left, kicked him in the head, left.
Yeah, that's what it looked like when I saw it too. It was, he wanted to kill him. You know what I mean? It was clear. It seemed very clear from the footage. It's not like I spray a little bit and run away. No, when you walk up on somebody laying down, bust at them while they're down, kick them in the fucking head. Yeah. He meant to do that.
The suspect's name is Eric Holder. He was essentially on the run for 2 days. Yesterday, he was apprehended by authorities after trying to check himself into a mental health facility in Bellflower.
So, do you think he's going to try to say he was crazy during the time? Is that...
If I'm him, I mean, I think he probably will want to. And early descriptions of him that just came out of the community, people were there, people who knew him and Nipsey, said that he was a bit on the spectrum. He wasn't necessarily all there all the time. So I think that's probably what will happen. I think the attention now shifts, now that he's in custody, the attention shifts to what charges he will face ultimately. And then whatever his defense will be.
It looks like murder one, bro.
Sure.
Yeah. You walk up, it's one thing, in argument, I start spraying cats and da-da-da, but, he was very, when you walk away and then come back, twice?
Yeah. It's this is one of the last things that you expect to happen to someone who has meant so much to that community, but community in general. As Nipsey Hussle.
Yeah, it's,
and he's in front of his own store in his own neighborhood where he came up selling socks, built a legacy of family, education, financial literacy.
Yeah.
In this neighborhood. That spread around the world. People know more about Nipsey Hussle than they know about Nipsey Hussle's music. He's not someone that I think most people can name their favorite Nipsey song. That's how big his impact is.
Yeah. What I always liked about Nipsey was his creative way of marketing himself. Was it the $10,000 records?
He did the Crenshaw for... The Crenshaw mixtape, he sold $100. Mixtapes were sold for $100 each.
Yeah.
And he only had 1,000 copies. I was there that night outside of Youth Boutique.
That's really thinking outside of the box. It takes a creative, intelligent person to come up with that as a plan. I didn't listen to a bunch of Nipsey's music, but I did get to meet him and interview him, and just stand up dude. Like, he was just a stand up cat. Like, he was really he was bright and he, and it seemed like he was trying to look out for his area, you know.
Super solid. Looks you in the eye when he talks. Quiet confidence. He's one of those guys where you would have at every point in his life, especially in his public life. I was fortunate enough to call him a friend. And people older than him with more experience looked up to him. Mm. He carried himself with wisdom, with perspective. He was a light and a beacon. I'm not one of these people who says, oh, the hood is all nothing but plight. There's plenty of beauty. There's plenty of positivity. There's plenty of positive people. Very few ever in life have that type of impact, that type of connection with people that they're not even that close with. Nipsey will ask you about your family and if they hadn't, and if he hadn't seen you in a year. You know, he's so much more than... I say this with no hyperbole, right? And there's a few different reactions that we have here for different people. This is like RFK being assassinated. This is like MLK. This is like Pac. This is different than Biggie, right? This is someone who made an impact with people through his energy, his words, his messages that wasn't necessarily tied to a product. Just things he was doing to make other people's lives better.
Yeah, well, is it true that he was supposed to be going to like meet with the cops to help out with like a gang reach out program?
Reportedly. And you know, the thing that is so crazy about this is that there's been so many different stories and narratives that have just been spilling everywhere since this took place on Sunday. One of them was that he had a planned meeting with the LAPD and they were supposed to talk about progress in the community to some degree. I'm not sure. I don't know how, whether that's been officially corroborated or not. I wouldn't put it past him, you know? And I think it's something he cared about. There was another story that there was heightened security at a video shoot recently that took place in a parking garage in LA. This is for a DJ Khaled song. It'll be on DJ Khaled's album. So there's stories out there that talk about, you know, there was a little pressure around Nipsey. I'm not sure that's 100% been corroborated. I know people are reporting on that. TMZ reported today that one of the big questions is, why was Nipsey outside of his store, broad daylight, no security anyway, if that's how things have been recently. TMZ reported today that he went to the store, his store, on his block, because a friend of his got out of jail after being in jail for 20 years and needed some fresh clothes before he went home, which is a very Nipsey thing to do.
Who else was hit? And
there's two other people. I'm not sure their names have officially been released, but they survived. And if they have been, then maybe Johnny can double check to make sure if we can have those other guys' names out there. I don't have them in front of us. There was a memorial service the following night that took place outside of the Marathon store. We have a video up here. I'm not sure if there's sound. I'm not sure on this necessary clip.
Yeah, what happened with the memorial service?
So there's thousands of people in the mini mall where Nipsey's store is, and reports were that shots went off and people got stabbed. The next day, during a press conference with the LAPD and the mayor, the mayor speaking on this. This is the impact Nipsey also has. Someone apparently had a gun, showed a gun, and people got scared.
Okay.
Then ran away. And because there's candles, it's a vigil. People fell on candles and people tripped and got cut by glass. Like, there wasn't...
So there wasn't any stabbings. It was someone was running from a gun.
There's been so much misinformation around everything around this because people are grieving. Like, people are literally just trying to figure out.
And it's literally the game of telephone. You know what I mean? It's like, oh, I heard this, I heard that, I heard this, I heard that. By the time it gets to me, I'm like, I heard he's supposed to meet with the cops to help gang outreach. You know what I mean? Like,
the first, I'm definitely someone who believes just because it's a conspiracy doesn't necessarily mean it's a theory, right? I say that hierarchically. Right, from a macro standpoint. The first thing people were saying about this after this happened was that this was the this was retaliation for him making a documentary on Dr. Sebi, who was a holistic healer who reportedly was able to cure AIDS and cancer and all these people who was murdered in 2016. There was a trial in 1985, and he actually got off because he proved it, but no one wanted to talk about it. So he's making this documentary. So people believed initially that this was a product connected to that. I mean, that's how much this doesn't make sense, Jude. Everybody is literally trying to come up with reasons why something like this would happen to a person this solid in front of his store on his block where he's a pillar of the community. The 60s is one of the most important blocks in Los Angeles. Los Angeles is one of the most important blocks in the country. The country is one of the most important countries in the world. This is one of the most important places on the planet. This is so outside the box. People are in pain.
Well, you were his friend. How are you doing?
It was tough.
Yeah.
It was definitely tough. This is the first time I've ever cried over the passing of a public figure.
Yeah.
You know, there are echoes to Pac. There's a lot of Pac comparisons coming up, you know, coming out around this. And I think part of it has to do with one of the things about Pac was that, you know, all those guys, everybody back in the day, all of our entry points was the music. So we were all, I think we knew more music, more songs from the people who were celebrities or people on the radio then because we just had the same filters. But Pac stood out because we saw him on the news. We saw his interviews. We saw him spitting at cameras. We had all these other, we saw him in movies and films and all these other things. And I think a lot of that shifted to where, generally speaking, we see more of everybody and hear less of their music and their product that they're actually selling. The power of Nipsey Hussle came through in not only his music, but through his interviews. Like, there's an interview with him in 2006 talking about, we need to all invest in real estate. There's no time to have gang-on-gang violence. We're dividing and conquer. We can't do that. Like, he's talking to grown men.
Yeah.
Tiny Loke with a tiny Jerry curl.
Yeah, he definitely had a vision. He saw things in a much... He had a further vision than a lot of people. A lot of people can't see past this next hour or next day. And he really had a vision. You could just tell by the way he approached the game.
Yeah.
Something else that hasn't been brought up between the two of us was really Los Angeles wasn't doing much in music. They really weren't making a lot of noise. It was a lot of shit was coming out of Atlanta. You had some shit coming out of like St. Louis and some Midwest shit. And
random places.
New York, yeah, random places. But LA really wasn't doing shit for a long time. And Nipsey was that guy that was like bringing LA back. And I don't think he really gets the credit for it that he deserves. But he was that guy that helped pave the way for these 20 other MCs that are out now that are on the cover of magazines and getting accolades. Could they have got that without Nipsey? Yes, possibly they could have. But the fact is Nipsey did shine a light back towards Los Angeles. Like, nah, we doing some shit out here, man.
Yeah. And he stayed down. Like, he wasn't trying to get love and accolades from other places. He was focused on L.A. Like, a lot of people, when they get their first check or they get their first advance or they get their first investment, they can't wait to go other places and help spread their gospel on the road. Not saying Nipsey didn't do that. He was focused on home, which I think is a little bit different than the way artists were being marketed and promoted at that time. We're talking about the mid to late 2000s.
It did seem, that's having strong enemies is a blessing.
That was his last tweet.
Yes.
And
what do you think? Do you think that is tied to the murder?
In my mind, it doesn't make sense for it to be tied to what this altercation is being described as between Nipsey and Eric Holder. The guy's name is Shitty Cuz, by the way. That's what they called him, Shitty Cuz, reportedly. The guy's name's Shitty. Can't make this stuff up. But I can't see that guy being a strong enemy, right? He's a reportedly, he is a known snitch in the area who was mentally ill, on the spectrum, allegedly. I'm not sure that is the type of tweet you direct at someone like that.
Yeah.
So I don't know. Maybe, I mean, these are the things that sparked all these conspiracies around.
But, like, yeah, that's what I'm saying. Maybe they weaponized the dude. Maybe they fucking...
You know, there's so much conjecture. I just hate, and I hope that throughout all these conversations, we don't lose sight of the fact that this is a person. You know what I mean? Like, this is... There was a candlelight vigil in New York City. We have a clip of it. I'll play it a little bit later or whenever, but... This is a national story. When's the last time an artist passed away? Like, love and respect, no disrespect to Prodigy. People probably can quote more Mobb Deep songs than they can Nipsey songs. This is a national story. People all over the country are reeling and felt this in different ways. I don't know if the conspiracy stuff, you know, connects...
To be fair, Prodigy didn't die of, it wasn't murdered, so...
Either way, yeah. You know what I'm saying? So, no disrespect. You know,
What about the... Like, I don't even want to start comparing what dead guy got more fucking hype than the next dead guy. I don't want to go down that road, but like...
Right. But this is the thing, right? I mean, this is someone who connected past, quote-unquote, his product, and that's... I don't know if that could be defined in, you know, what bigger hand was behind this tragedy. I mean, look, like, hypothetically, you have these conversations about anything, you know? But this is...
Let's go to the phone line.
This is different.
Josh in South Carolina. Go ahead, Josh.
Hey, yeah, Jude. Real quick, I just wanted to say, first of all, rest in peace to Nip, because, I mean, the dude was amazing, honestly, as a great human being, a great man, great rapper. And what I was saying earlier was that I feel like there's a lot of people who probably didn't know him that well, and they're kind of like, you know, giving condolences, and those people are getting flack online. And, you know, my personal take on the whole thing is that, I mean, let people just give condolences, you know. Everybody does that to people they don't know. If you find out that your bag clerk died, you'd be like, oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Doesn't mean you're a fake person because you never talked to him, you know? So I just think that a lot of people should take that in mind whenever they want to, oh, you didn't know him, you never listened to him. Well, yeah, okay. But it's an innocent black man that got, well, not innocent, but, you know, he got murdered. You're sad about it, so.
Yeah, I think people are allowed to mourn. Unfortunately, a lot of times people do post, they post tragedies for likes. But I'm not gonna, I got too much time on my hand, or too much shit on my plate for me to be looking through Instagram and yelling at people. I mean, even right. I got it, cause I posted a picture of, Nipsey and myself after the interview. Mm-hmm. And because we played the interview, because we wanted to honor him.
And, wait, you called flack really for posting?
Oh, yeah. Really? You never bang Nipsey. It's true, I don't. I listen, the only rap shit I listen to is out of Detroit for the most part. But that doesn't mean that I didn't respect him as a man. It doesn't mean that when he came and sat in this chair you're sitting in, that we didn't have a fucking good conversation. And I got to learn even more about him, and my respect for him grew even larger. I already respected him. Selling art is hard. It is a hard thing to do, and he'd been doing it for a long time, and he'd been doing it fucking like on his own. So like I already had that respect for him, and it was like I felt grateful to be able to sit there and chop it up with him. And
I didn't realize people were out there catching flack for even posting about the. Like, that's a.
It's got like, and I don't even want to go down that road because it's like I don't like. It's just people are so fuck. you know, what do you know about him? Like, what do you know about this? Right. Like, well, I talked to him. You didn't. So more than you, bitch. Like, get the fuck off my goddamn timeline. We're trying to do a rest in peace for somebody. Right. I didn't even answer none of these cats, but it was just like, all right, man, whatever.
The one I did see was, the cat posted on Instagram. Well, Young Scooter posted on Instagram. He was like, we need more cats like Nipsey Hussle. Legends never die. It's too much greed and cats hating on their own people. Just wait your turn, play your position. And the Future came in after that and said, yeah, we do need more people like us. I've been teaching and preaching for a decade, also showing and proving what hard work and dedication get you. And then someone responded right after that at Future. Hell no, you haven't. Cut the crap. All you taught us how to do was be a fly, depressed drug addict. Fuck out of here. I mean, the idea that
there's something to be said for fly, depressed drug addict.
I mean, it's
being one myself.
You know, I mean, it's. I think all this is, largely part of the grieving process, you know.
Let's go to Rick in Denver. Rick.
Yeah, I definitely think the elites is messing up, y'all, because this reminds me of Michael Jordan's dad in the shooting when those two guys were supposedly toting his cell phone after the murder. So when I saw the video of the guy that shot him currently, so when they shot Nipsey and he's bragging about it, saying, yo, I shot Nipsey, right in front of his daughter. Now, this is where the elites is messing up, and this is definitely conspiracy related, because someone that was talking about Dr. Sebi or CB, however you pronounce his name, and his holistic treatments, and then someone who's trying to, revitalize the community, that's where these guys is messing up, because they think we're stupid and we're not. Because anyone that tries to change things for the better, if you look at anyone, Martin Luther King, Gandhi, anyone, John F. Kennedy mentioned these guys right before he was done, and then they get killed. So that's just what happened, and there's no doubt about it. You put the puzzle pieces together, you can figure that out, right?
Let's go to Lynn in Los Angeles. Go ahead, Lynn.
Hi, how you doing?
I'm all right. Go ahead.
I just want to say this whole thing, it wasn't because he was about to do a documentary or nothing like that. He didn't want Shitty up there. He asked him to leave. And he told him, you're a snitch, don't nobody want you around here. And he left and came back with a gun. And he didn't have to do that. You took a good man life. I support this man. I used to buy CDs from him when he was selling them out here in Food for Less parking lot. And every time I see him, I go support his business, or I go to Master Burger. I see him outside. He'll wave. He'll give you a hug. Hello. He was just friendly like that. And his bodyguards wasn't there because they had went to go get him something to eat. My cousin is very close to him, so I know what I'm saying.
And to be quite honest with you, what you're saying sounds a lot more plausible than all of these crazy fucking theories. Like, what Lynn just said sounds much more plausible. Like, yo, dog, get the fuck away. We don't fuck with you no more. And dude gets in his feelings and comes back and shoots him. Thanks, Lynn. I appreciate you telling us your side. Hey, today, 742-3345. Kevin, Charlotte, go ahead.
Yo, what's going on, Jude? What's going on with y'all today?
Chilling, man.
What's up?
What up, though, Jude? Yeah, man, I just wanted to, just kind of give my piece. This whole Nipsey thing is ridiculous. Totally ridiculous. Though he was, he had a past of being in a gang and whatnot, he showed the afterlife of that gang. You know what I mean? Another example, Tookie. You know what I mean? Though he was imprisoned until his death, he showed that he could change. Now, Nipsey showed a totally different side of that. You know what I mean? He took Tookie's blueprint, no pun intended, to 10 times that level. You know what I mean? Tookie showed that he could change in jail. Nipsey showed that you could change on the street. You know what I mean? He showed people that were in gangs. He showed people that had degrees. He showed people that are still trying that they could still succeed. You know what I mean? Even if they didn't have what they needed, he showed like, yo, you can do something. You know what I mean? Even if you can't do it, I'm going to show you how to do it. I'm going to give you these hustle-nomics, these seven rules, or you know what I mean? He just, just overall good dude, man. And it's just sad, man. I actually shed tears in my car, man, on my way to work. I passed the church while another interview was going on. I passed the church named Victory, and I broke down, dude. I broke down, bro. Straight up broke down because that just kind of let me know, like, personally, like, yo, keep going, bro. Keep going. There's victory somewhere in your life. You know what I mean? And that was personal for me. So, you know, everybody got touched in some way, form, or fashion by this tragedy. And, you know, I just wanted to send my condolences to his family and, you know, anybody that was associated with him on a positive note. And it was definitely, definitely a senseless murder, man. Senseless murder, bro.
You said you're in Charlotte. Is that right?
Yeah.
Charlotte.
Say it again.
You said you're in Charlotte. Is that right?
Yeah, by way of Detroit, though. That's why I said what up, though, Jew. But, yeah, that's besides the point. Yeah, appreciate that, y'all.
All right, man. Southside Queens, DJ.
Yo, what's good?
Go ahead, man.
Like, on some real shit, me and my best friend had this talk Sunday all the way through Monday when she got off of work. Niggas acting like bitches and bitches acting like niggas. Just because somebody call you a snitch, you want to get mad? Like, who cares? You a snitch, you a snitch. You got a dip. You don't want you around the store, be out. Like, this is weird, yo. Like dudes just get mad, emotional over words. Trigger points.
Yeah, some of the...
And it's like, my whole thing is...
What's that?
Am I wrong? Am I wrong for saying, fuck gangbanging? Stop the Bloods, Crips, Essays, all that shit. And let's just unify and just stop everything and just start building each other up.
I don't think that's wrong to say. It's easier said than done. Quite. As long as there's some money and getting stuff, it's going to be people fighting over that shit.
I give Killer Mike so much props for that trigger warning show.
Yeah.
Where you showed the Bloods and the Crips.
Yeah.
And how they could make money like those biker gangs.
Yeah.
They could make... These are two of the most powerful brands, period. There's, right. You can even keep them and shift them and be more positive through the gangbanging side of it. Even though this isn't a gangbanging story, I feel where he's coming from.
Yeah, I hear. Carter in Los Angeles. Carter.
Hey, man, I just wanted to first off, you know, say my condolences and rest in peace to Nipsey Hussle, man. It's just, it's fucked up, man, that, like, people rise and do so much for a community and still nobody's untouchable. Like, it's a fucked up phenomenon that happens, man. It's like, that jealousy thing, it affects everybody and it gets to everybody. And certain people get to escape it, but most people don't. Like, I was one of those dudes that bit into the conspiracy theories and all of that shit, but... After looking at it and everything, it's really just some hood shit. It's some jealousy shit from a bitch-ass nigga, and it's kind of fucked up that that's really the way that the shit went down. That nobody's untouchable, man, and you could do so much for your community and, like, work so hard to build the fucking Marathon store and build so much up for this community, and then they fucking kill you in front of it. It's like, the shit's just crazy, man. It's fucked up. Just rest in peace to Nip. I've been slapping this shit ever since it happened. I've been listening to him since 08, since my freshman year of high school. So it's just fucked up, man.
Well, thanks for calling. You got any Nipsey Hussle pulled up? When we play a song, come back. 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345 is the number to dial.
I could drop a joint in there if it helps. We'll hustle and motivate.
Here, we'll do a... Last time that I checked, it was 5 chains on my neck. It was no smut on my rep. Last time that I checked, I was selling zones in the set. Make a quarter mil, no sweat. Last time that I checked, I'm the street's voice out west. Legendary self-made progress. Last time that I checked, first get the money, the respect, and the power in the hoes come next. Last time that I checked, I've been self-made from the dribble. I was been saying I'm a killer. Nah. Playing no games with you niggas. Pop clutch, switch lanes on you niggas. Nah. I laid down the game for you niggas. Taught you how to charge more than what they paid for you niggas.
on the whole thing for you niggas. Reinvest, double up, then explain for you niggas. It gotta be love. Run the city, it gotta be cuz. Just for the pieces I took off the Monopoly board. Hey, y'all niggas false claims, it gotta be fraud. Just keep the hood about your mouth or you gotta be charged. I doubled up, tripled up, nigga what? Banged on the whole game, I ain't give a fuck. Nobody tripping, handle business, got my digits up. And when I drop, you know I'm about to fuck the city up. Check, check, it was 5 chains on my neck. It was no smut on my rep last time that I checked. I was selling zones in the set. Make a quarter mil, no sweat last time that I checked. I'm the street's voice out west. Legendary self-made progress last time that I checked. First you get the money, then respect. Then the power and the hoes come next last time that I checked. Come through fly, check. No cosign, I ain't need radio to do mine. I done fine and I take my time. And take my tribe every level that I crossed in this game. Like stack lines, it was visionary. Either I'm genius or you niggas scared. Maybe it's both in this balance I deliver daily. For every nigga in these streets trying to feed the babies. The single mama's working hard not to miss a payment. And dirty money get washed on royalty statements. Black owners in this game are powerful races. Young niggas in the set just doing it makeshift. Out the garage, it's how you end up in charge, it's how you end up in penthouses, end up in cars, it's how you start off a curb server, end up a boss, it's how you win the whole thing and lift up a cigar with sweat dripping down your face. Cause the mission was last time that I checked. It was 5 chains on my neck. It was no smut on my rep last time that I checked. I was selling zones in the set. Make a quarter mil, no sweat last time that I checked. I'm the street's voice out west. Legendary self-made progress last time that I checked. First you get the money, then respect. Then the power and the hoes come next last time that I checked.
I got the front and in the back. We on the way and that's a fact. This real, this ain't rap. Where everybody wanna act pro-black. The last lie you heard, this ain't that. This, that, I did. Made it out the gutter shit. Nip told you fuck the middle man. I told you fuck a bitch. Fuck wearing they clothes, I wear my own shit. Y'all get on y'all label, I own my own, bitch. Hey, yeah, I remember all that game you throw me. Don't fuck around and get played by the label owners. Talk that shit to these niggas, Adrian Broner. But secure the window, don't let the game fool you. Cause when this game over, it's when the game over. And all they do is play the game till this game over. And you be giving game like a big brother mission. Never let them take it from us.
Last time that I checked, it was 5 chains on my neck. It was no smut on my rep last time that I checked. I was selling zones in the set. Make a quarter mil, no sweat last time that I checked. I'm the street's voice out west. Legendary self-made progress last time that I checked. First you get the money, then respect. Then the power and the hoes come next last time that I checked.
Shade 45, we are back. The company man, Justin Hunt, the company man on everything. Talking about the murder of Nipsey Hussle.
Last time that I checked, that's a great song, man. The Crenshaw album is underrated. I like the Crenshaw album. That's a $100 album. And the thing I like about Nipsey's music in general is that he does make motivation music. Like, you know, you listen to it, you wanna eat better. You listen to Nipsey Hussle, you want to be a better friend.
Okay. You know? Yeah.
Last time that I checked. First you get the money and respect, then the power and the hoes come next. So put that in order. You can live life by that.
Last time that I checked. Ain't that the truth? Let's go to Meech in Ohio. Go ahead, Meech.
What's going on, man? What's up? I was just really calling in, you feel me? We just ain't thinking about what's really going on. Like, Shitty's face got out of jail 2 days before the shooting happened. And then we only see one angle of the camera where he got knocked. You feel me? Like, if any nigga with common sense, I mean, it just makes sense. Like, Shitty's face was working with the Gov on this. Like, you feel me? That's all I'm trying to say. A nigga call you a snitch. Nipsey didn't call multiple niggas a snitch. That's Crips. Trust me. I got niggas that live in L.A., you feel me? I used to DJ for Cash back in 2015. And when we was on tour, you know, I met a couple of different niggas, you know what I'm saying? So, it's just, we thinking, oh, it's just a hate nigga. No, the nigga just was like, shit. The nigga, Nipsey's brother went to jail over a Shitty face. So, the whole reason he went to jail is because he Shitty face snitched on Nipsey's brother. So the police come to you talking about, yeah, we'll pay you to get this activist because he got a strong voice. You know what I'm saying? Why would he not do it if the numbers is right? And he know how he how Nipsey get around. Think about it. Back in 97, Biggie got killed by LAPD leaving the MTV Awards. It was paid by somebody. It was paid by somebody to do it. Now what y'all think?
I don't know. I don't have enough information to jump to those conclusions. Maybe. You know what? Maybe. Look,
but why though? Like, why? Like, you know, I don't have enough information either, and that's the thing that's so crazy. But why would the police want to kill Nipsey? Like, why? I don't know why the police would want to do that. I think if you kill Nipsey, for example, if you're the police, you're causing unrest.
Yeah, they're like
you make things less stable.
They're like, you know what? We don't got enough shit to do down here. Let's fucking go do that. Like, I don't think. Look, man, I don't know. I don't know what happened, and I'm not going to pretend like I know. I saw the fucking video. I didn't enjoy watching it. It was fucked up to see. Talking to him as a fucking just like as a man, I left that interview with. I already respected him a lot, and I had even more respect for that cat after chopping it up with him. Like, it was fucking, it was really cool.
And you said that was leading up to Victory Lap?
I believe so. I was on a lot of drugs when that shit happened, so.
It's his Grammy-nominated album.
Yeah.
Appropriately titled.
Not bad, man. Not bad for your first album. Now, I remember that during the interview, I was like, that was your first album? You've been doing this for so fucking long. And he was like, all the other ones are like mixtapes. So I was like, that's fucking cool, dog.
These new rappers and these new labels with these projects. They're all collections of songs. It's crazy. 49 singles, 13 mixtapes. Victory Lap's first studio release.
Let's go to Tom in Florida. Go ahead, Tom.
Yeah, man, I just want to say, you know, I've been hearing all this shit about this man, you know, where he came from, about how can you respect him, he was gangbanging and all that shit. I just want to make sure motherfuckers know, man, that it ain't always about where you from, man, because sometimes where you grow up at, you know, you got to do certain things. You got to look at where that man was going. Like, that was a positive-ass nigga, man, and I hate that a motherfucker get on social media and say, well, how can you do this because he's gangbanging and this and that. All that bullshit is aside. This man was doing positive shit. Like, you got to respect where a man coming from. You got to respect where a man going at. Like, all that negative shit, man, I'm just tired of hearing it, dog. And that shit really got me upset. And well, I just want to say rest in peace to that man. You know, blessings and condolences to his family and all that good shit, man. And, you know, put some respect on that man's name. Fuck that bullshit, man. That's all I got to say.
One of the realest things I learned when I first moved to L.A. was talking to people who are from L.A. And they would say things like, I don't understand how you can grow up in L.A. and not be in a gang. Right? Like, these are just my friends. It's based off of literally where I live. And not because everyone is gang affiliated. It doesn't mean they're necessarily banging.
Right.
It's a different perspective if you're not from here. It's one of the first things I learned when I got here. And it resonates all the time, especially when I was listening to this caller. You know, there's a perception that just because you rep something, it means that you're active in a different kind of way. That wasn't Nipsey, apparently.
Yeah, and it's like, on a deeper level, is your whole life defined by things that you did in the past or what you're doing now? I think it all weighs out, you know what I mean?
I mean, and the one thing that's so wild is Nipsey's been doing this for so long that I don't truthfully have any negative gangbanging related, gangbanging related connotations with him. You know, I've seen altercations on TMZ, but they weren't anything serious. And nothing outside of, I've seen Will Smith smack a camera guy on TMZ, you know. I've seen people do
Kanye did the same shit.
Right. You know, like, outside of that, I don't even have that as part of his brand to me. Now, Suge Knight always has that to me. Nipsey doesn't.
You don't say. Let's go to Mike. Go ahead, Mike.
Hey, I just wanted to talk about the special needs aspect or the spectrum aspect.
the fact that I'm a coach for special needs, and I've seen it a couple times where people that have special needs, they'll get off on like charges because they have special needs. No prosecutor wants to touch that. So I hope that's not the case. But yeah, I just wanted to talk on that, and then hopefully you can play Blue Aces too.
Because you're saying, oh, my man tried to turn himself into the fucking crazy ward. Therefore, he's already setting up a case for himself to have special needs and get treated nicer. Is that?
I mean,
exactly.
Yeah. I mean,
yeah. That's the shitty part of it that you hope that doesn't happen, but
and that's
usually with special needs, no prosecutor wants to touch that shit.
It's kind of funny, man. This guy sounds brighter than one would think.
I mean, if he made those choices on his own, he leisurely left the scene with the woman driving the car. So, Bellflower's about 20 minutes from Crenshaw and Slauson. Is the caller still on? Is the key still on?
Yeah, I'm still.
So you think that there's a, or at least from a history standpoint, these kind of cases tend to lean in favor of the mentally ill?
Usually mental ill, they'll not charge a person as bad. They'll put them in a mental rehab, things like that. But
man, that sounds really calculated, bro. That sounds really calculated. Yeah, well, most people don't think to turn themselves into the crazy ward. They think to turn themselves into the fucking cops. Like, I haven't thought about that. This is going to be interesting how this turns out. That's kind of why I don't want to, like, I'm only going to speak on what I fucking know. Like, we don't know. There's so much that we don't know. Did Shitty admit to it, or
as of yesterday, he hasn't gone on record and said anything yet.
So we have to say all of this shit is alleged.
Yeah,
just
I mean,
so y'all know everything about Shitty is alleged.
There's a bunch of YouTube videos with people supposedly DMing him. I can't corroborate any of that. I'd rather not.
Right.
You know, fan. You know, fodder for whatever.
It's,
but he hasn't gone on record yet. I mean, that's where it is.
So yeah, it is alleged that he shot Nipsey. Well, Jess, man, I hate that we had to have this conversation today. I really do, man.
Me too, man. You know, it's the one thing that I think that can come out of this is that it does, in the worst possible context, you know, it's another opportunity to really let people know you care about them. You know, I made a lot of phone calls to just friends and family after this. Was like, yo, I really appreciate you. You know, I'm thankful you're around, because in a speed of a right click, everything could change.
Yeah.
And this wasn't, I mean, everything about this seemed really fluky. Let's take Lynn, what the caller said, as truth, for example. Security left to go get some food. You know. Let's take this kid be on the spectrum, for example. Maybe he just reacted differently. Maybe there's some personal. Who knows? But maybe it's a car accident for anybody else. I made a lot of phone calls to family and friends after this happened. And I'm thankful for everything Nipsey gave us before he passed away.
Yeah, study is hustle, yo. That's the one thing I really study Nipsey's hustle. I gave him shit. He went out and got it. And I really respect that.
Word up.
Rest in peace to Nipsey. And just thanks for coming through, man. Appreciate you, Doc.
The marathon continues.
Let's go.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
In what might possibly be the most controversial feature on the radio today.
Bitch, don't play that shit on this radio no more.
This is the place where careers are made.
That shit was awesome. I love it.
And broken.
Yeah, what's up, you fucking poser, man? That shit was whack.
It's time for Hate It or Love It on Shea 45.
We're going to Virginia. We got 90 Wise.
Yo, dude, bro, what's good, dog?
Shit chilling, man. How you doing, 90 Wise?
I'm doing great, bro. This fucking phone calls nigga John gave me yesterday, yo, it's fucking crazy, yo. Mad respect, yo. Mad respect to what you do. I fucking go home and I listen to y'all shit all the time, so.
So you
all love, bro.
All right, so you listened to Hate It or Love It and you still wanted to sing your song in?
Yeah.
All right.
What do you mean? Like, if your people are fucking ruthless, yo. You know what I mean? That's what it needs to be, for real, for real.
All right.
So it is what it is out there.
And John was fair with you and everything?
Yeah. John was cool, bro. Why y'all fuck with so much, dog?
I don't know. I just look at him and want to fucking hit him.
I did look at his Instagram today, and I was like, yo.
It's on fire.
Kind of like, yeah.
He said it's on fire. All right, man.
Yeah,
yo,
John was,
90 Wise, what do you do when you're not rapping? What do you do for money?
I'm a beer merchandiser.
So what does that mean?
Pretty much like, you know, you go to like the fucking local grocery stores and shit. Like, I pretty much put up the beer and all that.
So you slang, you'll be like, okay, you need, you got, have you thought about carrying flat tire, whatever the fuck it's called, shit like that?
Nigga, nah, I'm not the salesman. I literally come in, I put the beer up, and then I sit, I'm out. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, okay.
The salesman do all that shit, and the truck drivers just bring the shit through. All
right.
Chilling.
Okay, let's talk about the song. It's called Gatsby.
So, yes, sir.
Tell
me
about it.
So about the song is fucking to boy Grace, Grace. So we pretty much wanted to come up with just some nasty ass like hip hop, like boom bap shit, and just really just say like, you know, like as far as like these bars and shit are concerned, like in Virginia, like Nova, at least a 703-504 type size shit, like we are fucking recognized and we need to be fucking recognized for our bars and our hip hop and how hard we fucking go. So,
well, how long you been rapping for?
So I've been rapping for about 3.5 years now. So I'm still primarily you know, new to the game.
All right, relatively.
Always a student though.
Okay, we're gonna play Gatsby right now. Is it just you rapping, what? Or is there other people rapping on it too?
Nah, it's just me and my boy, Young Pro. He did the scratching at the end. So,
all right, here it is, Gatsby from 90 Wise. Call us up. Let us know whether you hate it or love it. Today 7423345. That was Gatsby. It's Hate It or Love It. call us up and let us know how you feel about the song. I got my man 90 Wise on the line. 90 Wise, are you ready to talk to some people?
Yes, sir.
All right, 888-742-3345. Let's go to Houston first. We got Preem the Co. Prometheco. What's your name, man?
It's Preem. Preem the Goat.
Oh, they murdered your spelling.
Damn.
Yeah. All right, whatever, Preem the Goat. Do you hate it or love it?
Man, that shit was ass, bro. Like, come on now. Y'all know I'm playing good shit, man. But come on now, man. That shit was ass.
You bugging.
Hey, no, bro. You just need my practice.
Bugging. But, hey, you got your own opinion. And that's like bugging. Like, I don't know who hip-hop is. I don't know how you interpret it, but.
So you're saying he doesn't know what hip-hop is. Preem, he says he don't know what hip-hop is.
Man, I'm a producer, bro.
Okay.
I produce. I know music.
So anything we might have heard?
What's up? I can't hear you.
Yeah. Trippy in L.A. Hate or love it?
What up, Jude? Man, I fucking hate that shit.
Yo, that dude. My man hung up the phone. I heard the click, man. He hung up.
Who hung up? I'm here.
90 Wise.
Garbage.
Yeah, it was garbage. You wasn't fucking with it.
Nah, I was feeling that Nipsey you're playing a few minutes earlier.
Yeah,
this bullshit came on. I almost fucking went back to my playlist.
That's understandable. Sorry.
Mm-hmm, dude. Yeah, man. That shit ain't music to my ears, man. That shit's pretty disappointing there. Gotta hate it.
Okay, it's a hate. All right. It's two hates, no loves, and we're trying hard to get 90 Wise back on the phone. Turn on the mic, John. Where are we?
Yo.
Okay,
what's up? 90 Wise won't answer the phone now?
Yeah, there's something strange going on.
He got cussed out. What the fuck happened?
No, he was fine. We had a good talk about it yesterday. He seemed okay with the whole thing.
Dog.
What the hell?
I heard it go click. I heard a click. It wasn't like a disconnected. Whoosh. Fuck it, man. I'll just keep taking calls. 888-742-3345. Sam in North Carolina. You have to speak loud because
he's there.
Okay, we got him back. What happened to you?
Man, that was such a goofy ass comment. Leave that shit alone for a second and come back. But no, I lost service.
Oh, you lost service? All right. Let's go to Sam in North Carolina. Hate or love it, Sam?
Hate it. That shit was straight ass. Like, it just fucking sucked.
Damn.
Like, nigga, go get another career, man. Like, stop fucking rapping.
Why you talking about some song, nigga? Sound like you got fucking 10 thumbs and you gripping the phone hard as shit. Relax.
Man, that shit was fucking ass.
Nigga, you're ass. Nigga, you don't know what hip hop is. Cool.
Nah, man, you just fucking suck.
Let's go to Mike.
Cool, bro.
Mike in Toronto.
Yo, man, is this shit a fucking joke? Like, it's not April Fool's. Fucking disgusting. That song is disgusting. You're a disgusting human being.
Damn.
You're even coming to this fucking show, bro. What is wrong with you? I hope you get punched in the fucking throat. Damn. You're shit. Your music is shit.
So, are you done?
I hate it. Your music is shit. Why do you make your voice sound like that? You sound like you're a fucking...
That shit got you upset, didn't it? That's the whole point of it. You feel that hip-hop? You feel that hip-hop?
I put him on hold. He was yelling.
Yeah, I'm telling you, he's real upset, dog. Like,
Unit in Ontario, hate or love it?
Love it.
Okay.
Hey, that was some greasy shit. I love the beat, everything, dog.
Thank you, dog. Appreciate you, bro.
Fuck them haters.
I'm telling you, bro.
Keep doing your thing, dog. Peace out.
Peace.
I appreciate you, dog.
Tim calling from Jersey, hate or love it, Tim?
Man, look, man, it sounded like a fucking little kid fucking went crazy on the goddamn fucking turntables, man. Hey, it sounded like he's still drunk right now. That shit is fucking garbage, bro.
Right.
Garbage.
Are you sure?
Is that what it is?
Dude, I'm fucking positive, man. I'm a real big fan of fucking '80s and '90s fucking hip hop, and you know, if that was fucking hip hop, then if that's the fucking direction we're going in, we
bugging.
We
direction we're going in. Nigga, dead ass. Like, you sound like a goofy ass. The music is fire, my nigga.
Hey, keep trying. Hey, look, we love you out here, man.
Thanks for listening, bum ass nigga.
Buddy in Arizona. Hate or love it, buddy. Buddy. He's got his fucking phone up. Drew in Arizona. Hate or love it.
Yo, I hated that shit. That sounded like Insane Clown Posse trying to remix the Frank Ocean track.
Damn.
That was a reach, nigga. That was real bad, bro.
I don't get it.
Like, what's wrong with hip hop, bro? Like, what's wrong with the boom bap shit? Like, why are you doing that? Why are you still saying
my nephew's making better beats on Fruity Loops right now.
Like, your nephew asked about you.
He asked, why are you so upset, Drew? He wants to know.
Just the raspy shit, man. What's up with that?
Did you hear anything? So aside from the voice, nigga, you heard nothing else, which is crazy.
Yeah, man.
Touche. Got you there. All right, we're gonna keep it moving. 888-742-3345. Sicily in Maryland. Go ahead, Sicily.
Hey, it was trash. Damn. I'm sorry. You should not quit your day job. Just stay with what you're doing. Keep delivering beer. But this is not your calling.
So motherfucking,
you need to let this
backward.
Go. It was absolutely.
You got that motherfucking Trevor's trailer off this day. You want somebody backwards?
I almost veered off into like.
I wish you did.
Oncoming traffic. This is absolute garbage. I'm from the DMV area.
That would have been the perfect song.
But you know better than this. You know that that's the perfect not how we song. Out here, and you just embarrassed
the
whole area.
You should have rocked into that oncoming
absolute
traffic.
Trash.
You should have rocked into that oncoming traffic.
Shame on you.
I guess so.
Do better.
Swerve in the traffic next time. So you don't have to make that phone call.
I mean, fine, if that's how you want to play it, but you know, and I know, that was garbage.
I don't know.
You should be embarrassed.
All right, let's go to Mike and Cali. Mike. Mike.
I like the lyricism, but him screaming on it, that's probably why he's getting so much flack.
So you loved it, but you're saying him yelling on it is probably
that's
why.
That's crazy.
All right.
I think it's just the presentation, you know what I mean?
I mean, it was a whole vibe for the whole entire song. I mean, it was, if you listen to it, it just seems like motherfuckers get turned off from the voice, and then, like, everything else kind of just demeans after that. Like, the scratching, the beat, like, that's crazy. I mean, I know niggas gonna hate, and that's what it is, but that's crazy.
The crazy thing, 90-wise, is it didn't sound like the way you talk right now, it didn't sound like that when you was rapping.
Yeah, because it's that energy that pulls me in when I fucking do that shit. When them beats come on and something else, I don't go into my shit and just start screaming and doing that. It's a whole vibe. If you actually go through my discography, I have plenty of songs where I'm not quote unquote screaming or whatever. But it's a whole different type of thing. I'm not trying to just scream to be different. Like, that's not a thing.
Aaron in Arizona.
Dude, that shit is trash, bro. Stick to fucking selling IPAs, bitch. I'm serious. That shit is garbage.
Nigga, take the phone out your mouth, nigga. You fucking listening with your PS4 fucking
IPAs. Hey, Cincinnati, hey, y'all rap game, shit. It sucks. Damn. You need to come harder than that, man. It sound like you doing some heavy metal type shit. Dude, it's 45. We don't got no time for that shit.
I'm trying to figure out how you even have Sirius without poor your fucking connection with, nigga.
Bro. Hey, hang yourself. That's what you need to do. And hang that nigga back there scratching on your fucking beat. That shit is garbage.
Hey, nigga, you're just mad, bro. Like, nigga, you just really
nah,
mad.
Nah, I ain't mad. Hey, nah, cut this nigga, dude off really the line.
All right, Big D in Austin. Big D, hey, I love it, Big D.
I fucking hate that shit, bro. Damn. That shit was horrible. When the fuck did Sesame Street get a goddamn record label? You sound like a motherfucking Cookie Monster. Fucking demon. sound like fucking trash, man. The dude scratching in the background. Fucking, is he even scratching, bro? That sounds like he's using his goddamn mouth. It sounds garbage, man. It's fucking bullshit. You need to take your goddamn computer, take your fucking CDs, your records, whatever the fuck it is, throw it in the trash, light that shit on fire, and watch that shit burn. That shit fucking sucks. You piece of fucking shit.
Damn.
You ever come back on this radio with that shit again, I'm, oh, I swear to God, that shit almost made my car lock up and go to the fucking right. That's how bad that shit was. That shit was horrible.
Thank you, my nigga.
You ain't got nothing to say on that one. I fucking stuck your ass on that one, you piece of shit.
I know it's not trash. You're just really upset, nigga. Like, you're truly invested in this, like, emotionally and physically.
Anwar.
Like, you're about to bust a vein, nigga.
Yo, what's up, Juke?
Go ahead, man.
Hey, check it out, bro. I didn't even hear your song, okay? I just got in the car after leaving the store. I'm going to tell you, after what just happened to Nipsey, he heard no 1,000 times, 1,000 or more, and he still pushed. So whatever these folks are telling you, they hate on you, excuse me, I'm getting emotional, shit. Keep pushing. That's the same thing I would tell my son or any other brother that's out there trying to do right. So it really don't matter what they call it. They're trying to show off for Jude a little bit, be rude the whole night. The thing is, brother, you keep pushing. If they don't like yourself, that's fine. It ain't for them. But you find your shit.
Leave me and Nipsey out of this shit. Real, man. Come on, man. Fucking leave.
That's crazy. I appreciate you, bro.
Curtin, Detroit.
Hey, I can't leave Nipsey out of this. You know why? I got 3 qualifying questions. I know I got a limited amount of time. Let me ask this guy 3 questions. First question, what's your ethnicity, bro?
African American.
All right. Okay. So you must have grew up in the birds with all that yelling and that metal. Second question, did you know you were coming after a conversation about Nipsey?
No, he did not.
No, I didn't know that.
No, you did not know that. Okay. That's not your fault. Third question is, did you know what type of station this is?
Nigga, what are you trying to get at?
Nigga, answer the question, nigga. Do you know what type of station this is?
Oh, station. Yeah, I know what kind of station this is, nigga.
You know it's a hip-hop and rap station, so get the fuck out of here.
Oh, my God, nigga.
Straight, dog. You knew what I was going to say when I came in, bro.
Oh, my God. Don't play with me, bro. Like, it's cool, you come home, bro. With like, you don't like
fucking
it.
Metallica cool. Mixed with rap type shit. Yeah, cut that out, bro. Right, I don't know. Where you from? Where you from?
You're reaching, my nigga. Where you from? It's cool.
Let's go to
cool. Virginia, nigga.
Greg in Texas.
You heard him, nigga. Fuck out of here.
What's up?
Go ahead, Greg.
I hate it.
Oh, all right. Well, that was quick and to the point after fucking, after Matlock asked you 20 fucking questions.
I'm a fucking professor.
Joel.
Yo, what's going on, Jude?
You got 90 wise. Hater love it.
Oh, man, that shit was fucking trash. I can't believe you even call that boom bap. That's like boom crap, buddy. Fucking 3.5 years of that. You must be in the fucking special ed fucking slow learning class. You need to fucking just quit that shit and fucking get on with your life. Because that shit was fucking whack.
Appreciate it, bro.
So,
What's up with niggas talking so strong on the phone? Like,
that was fucking trash, buddy. Fucking trash. Fucking. You know what you need to do? You told that last buddy of yours to fucking hang himself. You need to go into your fucking merchandising and fucking hang yourself from your fucking rafters, buddy, because you fucking suck.
Wow.
I never told anybody to hang themselves, and like I didn't even understand half of that. So.
Joe in Atlanta. Joe.
Yo, what up, everybody? Hey, can y'all hear me?
Yep.
Yo, what up, man? Hey, man. I liked it. It's a love for me.
Okay.
Keep pushing. Don't let nobody tell you. You know what I'm saying? That shit is trash. Everybody ain't going to understand your delivery. That's the whole point about it being hip-hop. It's art. It's creativity. It's something different. And what I learned and realized in life is niggas hate shit that they don't understand. So keep pushing, man. Don't let nobody tell you nothing.
All right.
I appreciate it, bro.
That was some love from I forgot where. Nick and Nolo. Is it Nolo?
What's good, y'all?
What up? Go ahead, Nick.
Yeah, that shit was crazy, man. That shit sound like George Burns fucked a Rottweiler and spit in a microphone, bro. I'm just saying.
No, you're good, bro. I appreciate it.
I'm just
it,
saying. That's just my... I wasn't feeling it.
All right. It's cool, bro.
Well,
wow. Bro. That was good.
Well, here we are.
Nigga, I know what the fuck it is. I know what the fuck I got. You're funny as shit.
Thanks, bro. You didn't get a W out of this one.
Yeah, I'm hip.
But you stood your ground, and that's more than most people would do.
Yeah, for sure, Joe. I appreciate everything, yo.
No doubt. And if you got another one, we'll put you on Hate or Love It again. All right, 90.
I got more shit. I got more shit. Maybe I won't bring the screaming shit. Apparently niggas don't like screaming shit. But irregardless, you appreciate you, bro.
There you go.
Virginia, you know what I'm saying? Represent.
All right.
Jew, have a great night, bro.
You too. That was 90 Wise. He did not win because you guys did not like it. That was Hate It or Love It. Don't go anywhere else. We got more fucking show to come. The news.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you. And now, it's time for News from the Chin with John Z. Matthews.
Looks like having a pretty wife or a rich husband maximizes life. And a maximizer is somebody who seeks the best possible outcome. So these guys that are always out there trying to do well in life, as far as they're concerned, they're looking for hot wives, and women are looking for rich husbands.
They did an article on that?
Oh, it's a whole thing.
So guys that bust their ass and fucking sacrifice everything, they don't want to fuck an ugly broad?
That is what the research shows.
And a lot of times those guys, what it doesn't tell you is, like, a lot of times they're not, like, emotionally that deep, you know? Like, they excel in different areas.
They're dicks.
A lot of times they're dicks, says the fucking poor guy. And this, like, I'm not saying they're not dicks, but a lot of times, like, yeah, they can't be dickish. So, fucking, they just need a trophy. Like, look what I do. Check out this car. Check out this chick I fuck. And the chick is happy being a trophy, even if she doesn't admit it to herself.
What do you think about women who seek out rich guys?
I think the majority of women date up. Isn't that?
Yeah.
That's. So most women date up.
But can't they find a good guy out there who's not?
Oh, he sounds so pathetic. Can't they find a good guy out there that's comfortable on the bus?
Treat him well. Love them for who they are.
Knows how to wear out a pair of shoes. You know, really break them in. Really break them in. I don't know. That's just the way it got. Like, it's, I ain't even mad.
But again, in the context of romantic relationships, maximizers are those who seek the best possible partner and who, over the course of the relationship, continue to compare their partners to other potential partners. Okay. But they're... It seems kind of superficial to me.
It is, man. I've met these couples before. I've met a lot of, like, these rich motherfuckers, man. They don't really feel shit deeply, you know? Like, it's about as deep as they can get is having a fucking trophy wife. Put some kids in. Have some good-looking kids. And the wife ain't got shit to do, so she just sits around and fucking remodels things and runs up shit on Amazon and guilt.com. I'm really just describing, this was a family my mom worked for. She was like the gardener and she wasn't getting paid shit. And like fucking dude, just some fucking asshole. And, you know, You just had some pretty fucking wife. Pretty calculating wife. I would sit around and order fucking Ralph Lauren everything.
Were they happy?
That's my whole point. Yeah. They're as happy as they knew how to be. You know what I mean? Some people feel things deeper. You know, I'm sure he's happy. He's fucking some blonde chick.
And finally, they pointed out here that maximizers can have an inflated sense of worth. So,
I mean, they already are worth more than you. You know what I mean? Yeah. They're worth more than me and you. So, like, how much more inflated can it be? They're already, like, above average. So that means they can look at most people and be like, I'm better than you fuckers. I'm better than you. I'm better than you. I'm better than you.
But are they? I don't know. I mean,
No, they're not. They go to bed crying. They cry themselves to sleep. They OD on the best fucking coke and heroin possible. While you sit there in your fucking... Do you have any art hanging on your wall in your room? Do you have any art hanging on your walls in your room, John?
No. I had a girlfriend come over once, and she saw the bare walls, and she said, are you depressed? I said, not really.
I'm just, you know, it's fucking rich guys. I think they're just better than me, man. Damn. Like, that whole shit was, like, just sneak dissing you. That whole article was, like, sneak dissing you. And you could just tell you was in your feelings, like, oh, this is bullshit.
I'm a good man.
Can a gal just like a guy for his personality?
Are you a maximizer?
I don't even know what that means.
I don't know. You seek the best possible outcome. I mean, who doesn't do that? I don't know.
You don't do that.
I never give up.
I wouldn't call myself a maximizer per se, but I'm a try harder. I try hard. I'm a hard trier. I'm working like four different things at once. So there it is.
For some reason, Elon Musk, he released this rap song. And I mean, it seems like a joke, but it maybe, I mean, I but not really, because Harambe died. I mean, I don't know.
He made a rap song about Harambe?
It makes no sense to me. And he released it over the weekend.
What?
Through his Emoji Records. R.I.P. Harambe. I mean, this makes no sense whatsoever. I even asked from the office.
This guy's a fucking genius.
Is this real?
He's like sick. What a genius. He's like, I'm gonna build spaceships and I'm gonna write rap songs about Harambe.
I just don't understand.
And like, oh, electric cars. I'm gonna make sweet ass electric cars too while we're at it. Please play me this. I gotta hear some of it.
Yeah,
oh.
Let me love you.
And we're thinking about you. That's him?
Yeah, that's him. That's what they're saying.
Oh my god. We
love you. Sipping on some bomb, baby, on our way to heaven. Amen. Amen. Smoking on some strong and gorilla zoo, and we thinking about you.
All we ever do,
thinking about you. We back at the zoo, man. Thinking about you, man. Where my girl is at, we miss you. We really miss you. We want you, yeah. I'm in.
This shit just tickles me so much.
Smoking on some strong and gorilla zoo. And we thinking about you.
About you.
R.I.P. Harambe. Sipping on that Bombay. We thinking about you.
Shout out Bombay Sapphire.
Amen. Amen. R.I.P. Harambe. We smoking on that strong. We love you. And we thinking about you. Harambe.
That's all.
Yo, that, and then the picture they got, it's like they got Harambe with the crown on. 1.77 million listens.
We love you. There you go.
R.I.P. Harambe, man. It just goes to show you that without auto-tune, anybody can sound like a fucking rapper.
I wasn't even sure it was him at first, but
might not be, but I can't disprove it. You know what I mean? When you put your thing through that whole fucking vocal cord shit, you should get one of those, so just so you can do like do it.
Auto tune.
Yeah, like can you auto tune? Can you process? Can we get an auto tune processor for?
Yeah, I can figure that out. It's certainly, I've got one.
We're only 7 years late on the fucking trend. R.I.P. Harambe. There was a on another note. There was like a study that music is worse than it. Than it's ever been.
I don't doubt that.
Yeah. It's like this music is, it has like, it's the most generic sounding shit that's ever been out.
The argument is though that people buy it and that's why they make it. That's just always the argument. Like, well, if people didn't buy it, they wouldn't make it that way.
Yeah, the market dictates. But like a lot of the ill, like a lot of the dope rap shit didn't go platinum for years and years and years and years. It was underground. It was literally on the fringes. It was fringe music. So there's just not that much fringe music anymore. It's all kind of just homogenized. Everything sounds the same bullshit. And they literally, like, they did fucking tests on all, like, thousands and thousands and thousands of songs and ran it through there. And they were just like, the music changes. They don't have that many music, as many music changes as they did back in the day.
Yeah.
The choruses are the fucking same. Did you see anything on that? Did you? Yeah, it's fucking nuts.
It's all like old stuff from like 2011, 2012.
I did it again with some Spanish fucking thing. They ran it through. So the R.I.P. Harambe sipping on some Bombay.
He's onto something.
He probably made a computer do that. He probably had a computer make the fucking whole melody and shit for him. I bet you he did. He's a computer guy.
Mm-hmm. Does seem weird, but I don't know. It's not terrible.
I mean, yeah.
Now, the government, the U.S. government, they are ordering or encouraging this Chinese company to sell Grindr. I didn't realize that, but that gay dating app, a Chinese company picked it up. So there's some concerns that they're combing through the data, looking to blackmail people and fuck with their shit.
Wait, Chinese people are so China's trying to buy Grindr?
No,
so
they already have. Which I had no clue about. But
so all right, so China's buying Grindr, bought Grindr to do what?
Presumably to make money, but I guess the concern is that since the government sort of controls everything, they can order companies to hand over data just like that. And the government's concerned that, okay, let's say you're in the military and then suddenly you can get blackmailed because you're on this gay dating app and your HIV status is known and all that kind of thing.
Yeah, that's going to happen. Yeah.
Doesn't seem good to me.
Doesn't seem good to you, John? Well, that's what, yo, dude, like, we're too far down the road. Even me, like, maybe when Grindr first came out or some shit, cats didn't realize it, but like, don't you know that whatever you think that you're getting, you're not getting it for free. Like, they're taking your information, they're taking everything they can tell about your ass, and they're going to use it. And they'll use it, they'll sell it to marketing companies, or they'll sell it to people like this shit. I don't know if China's going to go into the, to start blackmailing people with fucking AIDS. I think they're making more money than that. But I'm sure now they're going to be able to tell, like, how many, like, what the percentage of motherfuckers with AIDS are.
Yeah, throughout the whole world.
Start fucking slanging AIDS shit to whatever, I don't know, like AIDS sunscreen or whatever. Like, I don't know what AIDS people have. Special sunscreen.
Do they?
I don't know. Yeah. AIDS frisbees.
Maybe.
The gays like the frisbees, I've heard. The gays. I heard the gays enjoy a good game of volleyball on the beach.
I've seen it.
So maybe China will start doing, you know, target marketing to them.
So, but do you even, let's say, have Facebook still on your phone? I should really uninstall that, I think.
I got it, but I don't know what the fuck, like, but yeah, I got it on my phone. I don't even know how to get into it. I lost my fucking password a long time ago, so it's just...
But it seems like the apps there are just vacuuming up all this data.
It probably is, man. But, like, don't you feel like even if you erase it, it's still going to be there? Like, yeah.
I'm already screwed.
Yeah, it's like, oh, you think I'm gone? No, I'm not gone. I'm in the corner of your phone hiding. I'm taking all your shit. It's like a rap. It is a fucking rap. R.I.P. Harambe.
I can't get that out of my head now.
I fucking love Elon Musk, dude. I don't know a lot about him, but every time he shows up in the news, he's always doing something I think is cool.
He upset a lot of people smoking pot, though.
What's that?
He upset a lot of people smoking pot, though.
Look, I get it, man. These are shareholders. They don't want to see, like, the CEO of the company sitting around getting blown with fucking... getting blown with Joe Rogan. But that being said... you guys are fucking idiots. If you're like a shareholder in Tesla and you're mad that your guy's smoking weed with Joe Rogan, it's not the half of it. I'm sure they're doing like fucking, I'm sure these fucking CEOs, they bust ass, dude. They're working like 70, 80 hours a week. They're doing fucking tons of coke and shit. Fucking probably some meth. And go out and fucking have weird orgies with ecstasy and Viagra. Like, you're worried about the fucking... you worried about him hitting a blunt? Like, get the fuck out of here, you moron.
But would you be concerned if you were a shareholder or something like that, and he was out
hell
there?
No,
at least
dog,
in Harambe or something?
Hell no.
Doesn't seem a little weird? A little bit?
Did it make the price of the stock go down? I'll buy some.
Does it fill you with confidence that he's making wise choices, or do you care at all?
Are you saying a man can't make a fucking awesome song dedicated to Harambe? One of the we lost a good one in Harambe because that little fucking asshole child and the asshole mom couldn't watch her kid. Harambe was just being minding his business, being a gorilla. R.I.P.
All right.
Sipping on some Bombay. I don't even like Bombay. Now I don't even drink. Now I don't want to go sip on Bombay. See, that shit works, man.
Skrillex, he's that dubstep guy, and it looks like his
Skrillex. He's that dubstep guy.
I don't know. There was a study out which says that his music, in particular, will ward off a particular type of mosquito. So,
what a cool mosquito. Fucking a badass mosquito. Yeah.
It's called the yellow fever mosquito.
Yellow fever. That's when you like Asian girls.
Oh dear. Whoa. I don't know about that.
You never heard? No. Yeah. You never heard of it? Like, oh, he got the yellow fever. Just pissed off all my Asian girls. Oh, he got the yellow fever so bad. Oh, look at him. Oh, long face. Oh, his face like a chapstick. Oh, he got a yellow fever bad.
Kind of do.
Chapstick face.
Now, in insects...
oh, his face look like a spring roll.
low frequency vibrations facilitate sexual interactions, whereas noise disrupts their perception. Well, the noise.
Wait, play. So play this shit bums out mosquitoes.
In particular, this song. Scary monsters and nice friends.
Turn that shit off.
Imagine listening to that at home.
Bro. What is that? So my homegirl, this was like probably 8-9 years ago. No, I take that back. Five, six years ago. And she's like, I'm DJing a dubstep night. Come with me. And I eat a bunch of mushrooms and roll over there with her. It was one of the worst trips I've ever had in my life. It was one of the worst trips. Like, play that music. Alright, so like that shit's going on, and I'm fucking tripping balls, and it just felt like someone was just taking my head and just mushing it in the fucking ground, just mushing my shit, and I literally went to a booth and laid in the fetal position. I was in the VIP booth because she was the fucking DJ, and I was just laying in the fetal position like, please get this shit the fuck over with, dog. Wow. Oh, man.
Wow. How do people, what are they, like, moshing to that, or what do the people, how do even dance to that?
They do like a, they almost look like retarded cavemen. They're like, ooga booga, ooga booga, ooga booga.
But that will scare away mosquitoes. Supposedly.
Oh, that's going to scare him.
And multitasking with various screens and devices, let's say it's your smartwatch or your cell phone or your computer, this will add up to weight gain. So
weight gain? How come? Because you're like eating and not paying attention?
Yeah, it looks like it impairs self-control when it comes to eating, making it harder to resist the temptation to snack on unhealthy foods.
That must be. I had four bowls of oatmeal yesterday.
Is that bad for you? No.
I don't know. That's good for you. Just saying. Just saying, bro.
But are you sitting there on your couch looking at the phone?
No, I was laying in bed. I was sick, and I'd fall asleep, and I'd wake up, and I'd be like, I want oatmeal. I'm going to fucking walk my bitch ass. I'm like, yeah, oatmeal now. And I eat it, and I go lay back down. So yeah, there you go. You live, you learn. Alright guys, so watch out for that. More than one thing going on. And you do things poorly. That's what else I've heard. And I heard that even if, like, how I got my phone out, I should hide my phone. Cause even if your phone is out, it fucking, you're thinking about your phone a little bit. You can't focus all the way.
No.
And it makes you dumber. You lose IQ points. But there's just one thing I want to say. R.I.P. Harambe. Sipping on some Bombay. You got some good news?
It's a smash.
And now, time for good news.
There is this 13-year-old kid, and he is out of Nevada, William Preston. He knew his single mother, Crystal Preston, was struggling, so then he sold his Xbox, did some odd jobs, and then bought her a car, which is kind of crazy.
13-year-old son trades his Xbox.
Yeah. For the single mom who's going through a bit of a rough spot.
Three kids? Goddamn.
And we can hear mom talk for a second about it.
Is she British or some shit?
No.
LA, I'm so happy.
Crystal Preston lives as a single mom in Fernley with her three kids. And
why her name got to be Crystal?
It's all Crystal.
It's like the most generic white trash name ever. All right, keep going.
She's kind of cute.
He likes you.
The family recently starting life over from scratch.
Why? Why is the family?
That's when her oldest son, William, stepped up.
At my, you know, low point, here comes my son. You know, everybody goes through rough patches in their life, but, you know, there's good that can come from any situation, as long as somebody with a heart does it.
Outside of school, William does yard and house.
Well, it's struggling to play there.
So he does yard work, housework.
But he bought her a car.
Wow, imagine if she actually worked.
Come on.
Imagine what would happen if she worked that hard. It's amazing.
Well, 13-year-old kid helping her out.
Three kids. How many different dads you think? One.
They didn't get that specific.
Two dads. Yeah, two dads. Like she had a pregnancy as a in her teens, and then she met up with some dude. He was gonna hold her ass down, and then he knocked her up twice, and it was like, peace. I'm Audi 5000. Peace. Out this bitch.
Lots of eyeliner on that lady.
What's a what?
Eyeliner.
Yeah, she's trying to get a fucking another stepdad. This is a big chance. She's on the fucking... He was just tired of seeing me crying. Jesus fucking Christ. All right, man. That's the news. Good for you, kid.
William. Looking
out for your mom.
Billy Preston.
All right.
You're listening to the All Out Show with you.
All right, that was the show. I want to thank Justin Hunt for coming in and filling us all in on the tragic loss of Nipsey Hussle. Thank you, Justin. Rest in peace to Nipsey. Chris is on the boards. Just was filming this shit. I'm a fucking got a boot face. John. Come on, man. Come on.
I appreciate the love.
Come on, bro. Quit saying I look like a fuck some new Tims.
It's very popular.
You look like a New York dyke would wear you.
I'll project that.
A stud. Thank you, John. You did a great job today. And that was a hell of a find on that goddamn...
Hoo-wee.
On that hater, love it. Wow. You can bring him back. Danica on the phones. And Keenan, associate producer, handling all that shit. All the fucking shit to make sure the show runs fine. And Alex, the head producer. My name is Jude Anthony Angelini. You can go to my website, onemorejude.com. Why not Rude Jude? Because some fucking dickhead just got my shit. So it's onemorejude.com. Why not All Out Show? Because someone's squatting on that one too. Jeez. Fuckers. But onemorejude.com has everything you need. Has it all. Check it out. Check it out. Check it out. Check it out. Check it. And for shit from the show, at All Out Show on all of the social medias. All of them. All right, we out this bitch.